Welcome to Rebuild My Church Again, RMCA Bishop Channel. May God bless you for opening this channel and for the goodwill to listen to this spiritual talk. Therefore, now please relax and try to be calm within you for the next 7 minutes or so. Take a deep breath and experience the presence of God within you. Surrender all your problems and worries at the foot of the cross. As you listen this talk, God will show mercy on you. Today, let us reflect and pray along with Pope Francis on the subject of overcoming prejudices and fear of getting involved in the lives of others and follow the example of Jesus, who shared our wounds and healed our lives. Pope Francis has based his reflection on the gospel passage Mark 1:40-45, which tells us of the encounter between Jesus and the sick man who had leprosy, and how the Lord drew near to us, broke down every barrier, and touched our lives to heal them. He noted that lepers were considered impure, and according to the prescriptions of the law, were marginalized and excluded from every human, social, and religious fellowship. But Jesus allowed the man to draw near to him, even to the point of extending his hand and touching him. Doing this was unimaginable during those times by any decent man. But this is how he fulfilled the good news he proclaimed. God drew near to our lives. He is moved to compassion because of the fate of wounded humanity, and came to break down every barrier that prevented us from being in relationship with Him, with others, and with ourselves. Pope Francis explained here that there are two transgressions taking place. The first transgression is that of the leper, he said, whom, despite the prescriptions of the law, came out of his isolation and went to Jesus. This was not allowed. It was a kind of cruel social distancing, to the extent of totally excluding them, the lepers, from the society. The lepers were condemned to live in some designated leper colonies. The reason for this was that the man's illness was considered a divine punishment. But in Jesus, he is able to see another aspect of God, not a God who punishes, but a Father of compassion and love, who frees us from sin and never excludes us from His mercy. Therefore, the sick man was thus able to emerge from his isolation, because in Jesus he found God who shared his pain. The second transgression was that of Jesus. Then existing law prohibited touching the lepers. This was known to everyone. Untouchability was strictly observed by all without fail when it came to the unfortunate reality of the lepers. People were frightened of the lepers. They were frightened also of anyone who ever happened to come in contact with a leper. It was worse than someone who came in contact with a COVID-19 patient in our times. In those days, there was no protective kit to approach the lepers. It was in that situation that Jesus was moved, extended his hand, and touched him to cure him. Jesus could have healed this leper from a distance, as he had healed the daughter of Jairus or many others, the paralytic, just by commanding the sickness to go away. Yes, Jesus could have done that, but no, he did not want to heal him in such a manner. He wanted to show him his love and compassion. He wanted to convince him that even a leper is a valuable person. He wanted to proclaim to the whole world that it is wrong, absolutely wrong, to identify the person with his sickness and deal with him in that manner. He did not want to limit himself to the words, and therefore Jesus extended his hands and touched him, the Pope explained. To touch with love means to establish a relationship, to enter into communion, to become involved in the life of another person, even to the point of sharing his wounds. With that gesture, Jesus revealed that God is not indifferent, does not keep himself at a safe distance. Instead, he draws near out of compassion and touches our lives to heal it with his tenderness. God does not follow the protocol of social distancing. This, Pope said, is God's style: closeness, compassion, and tenderness, the transgression of God. In this sense, Jesus is a great transgressor, decrying the fact that in the world today, so many of our brothers and sisters suffer marginalization and exclusion because of social stigmas. The Pope invited, therefore, the faithful to break those barriers and get involved with their lives. Pope Francis said, Jesus tells us that God is not an idea or an abstract doctrine, but the one who contaminates himself with our human woundedness and is not afraid to come in contact with our wounds. Therefore, Pope urged Christians all over the world to go beyond the selfishness, calculations, or even fears that prevent them from getting involved with the suffering of others. Instead, he said, let us ask the Lord for the grace to find courage to emerge from our isolation and self-commiseration and open our hearts to a love that goes beyond the conventions, that overcomes prejudices and the fear of getting involved with the lives of others. Pope concluded, let us learn to be transgressors like these two, like the leper and like Jesus. Remember, only by breaking the rules in favor of the true suffering, we can rebuild the church. That's all for today. Keep maintaining the calmness in your heart that you experience now and receive my blessing. Please forward this talk to others for their benefit immediately after receiving the blessing. Please listen one more talk if possible after some time. It will bring you more God's blessings. Now please make an intention in your heart of an urgent need in your life. My blessing is for that prayer which you are placing before the Lord now. I pray that God gives you success and prosperity in everything and everywhere. Okay, here we go. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Wish you a good day. Yours in the mission of the church, Bishop Franco Mulakiel.